Welcome to the video news of the week. After months of speculation and false starts, a successful sale of the Balsams Grand Resort Hotel in Dixville Notch was announced this week by the Tilton Corporation. The buyers are two area men with strong North Country connections, Dan Hebert Jr., a Colebrook contractor, and Dan Diges, who parlayed a Colebrook dealership into a series of successful dealerships, including Berlin City Auto. The men paid a reported $2.3 million for the resort, which includes a hotel, the Wilderness Ski Area, and the Panorama Golf Course, forming a new partnership called Balsams View, LLC. The lead story in this week's Colebrook Chronicle provides full details of the purchase, which was inked on Tuesday evening in Concord. The pair planned to keep the hotel and ski area closed for up to 18 months, while much-needed renovations take place. They do plan to open the historic ballot room at the hotel for the midnight presidential vote by Dixville voters on January 10th during New Hampshire's first-in-the-nation primary. Last week, the Chronicle spoke with Dan Hebert about the pending sale. We asked him whether the Northern Pass would gain an easement through the property, something the controversial power line project has approached the Tillerson Corporation. He told us, quote, "There will be no easement or land sale to the Northern Pass through Tillotson properties." The announcement first made on the Colebrook Chronicle's website on Tuesday night was viewed with a sigh of relief by Northern Pass opponents, many of whom sent letters and emails to the Tillotson Trust in recent weeks, requesting that no easement be allowed through the pristine properties. Meanwhile, it was also announced as part of the transaction that the Society for the Protection of New Hampshire Forests came to an agreement with the Tillotson Corporation to conserve much of the land surrounding the historic resort. This map, released this week by the Society, shows that land now close to development includes tracts sought by Northern Pass. After 15 years at the helm of Colebrook Elementary School, Principal Mary Jolles announced recently that she will be retiring at the end of the 2011-12 school year. In a story this week by Colebrook Chronicle's Brittany White, Jolles talks about her years at the school, saying that a highlight has been being at the school when the new elementary building was completed and opened its doors for the first time. SAU Superintendent of Schools Bob Mills commented on Jolles' tenure at the school and said that it will be tough to replace her. He said that the process of seeking a replacement is expected to begin after the holidays. Yesterday, House Bill 648, drafted by State Representative Larry Rappaport of Colebrook, went before an executive session of the Senate Judiciary Committee. Last March, the bill, which sought to amend RSA 371-1 to prohibit the acquisition of private land by eminent domain, passed the New Hampshire House by a 317-51 margin. Yesterday's vote saw an amendment attached to the bill, which opponents to the Northern Pass say effectively guts the bill's original intent to restrict the use of eminent domain for private gain. Shortly after the session, we spoke with Brian Bulldog Tilton, the host of The Pulse on WTPL Radio, who was at the session.
The Senate Judiciary Committee finally got around to doing an executive session on this bill. What they did was they passed the Carson-Bradley Amendment, which gutted House Bill 648 that the House passed, and that was to prohibit the petitioning by a public utility to the Public Utilities Commission for eminent domain proceedings for a transmission line project. That's what Larry Rappaport's bill would have prevented.
Now, the bill itself didn't specifically say Northern Pass, although the intent was there certainly to make it difficult for a private concern to use eminent domain. What did you see as far as opposition down in Concord today?
There were a number of people wearing orange who were holding signs outside, and a whole lot of people showed up. It was a standing room only crowd, most of them being opposition members. There were a number of lobbyists, for Public Service of New Hampshire as well as Northern Pass.
Now tell me about this clip that we're going to hear. You recorded. What are we hearing at this stage?
What a lot of people are seemingly concerned about is that the original intent of the bill was to prevent a utility company from even petitioning for use of eminent domain. My take out of it is that they have completely gutted that and then went ahead and said, okay, eminent domain is okay as long as you follow our rules that we just set forth here. I worry about the unintended consequences of that legislation.
The term that tripped up a lot of people also was system reliability. Where does that stand with this amendment?
It's gone. There's no reference to system liability. What I really think needs to happen is there needs to be a bill that will come into the legislature that will ask the legislature to specifically define what system liability is. This is where you're going to get a number of entities come in that are going to sit down and come up with a definition that everybody can agree upon.
Now, how can people, Bulldog, hear more of this? You've recorded quite a bit during the session itself.
This will be available on my website at briantilton.com. And click on the Northern Pass page, and then you just scroll down to the House Bill 648 executive session of December 8th, and I'll have very extensive coverage on my radio show, particularly on Monday, as I'm able to talk more about the Northern Pass project, as well as talk to Jack Savage from the Society for Protection of New Hampshire Forests about the easement that they're seeking to acquire on the Balsams property.
We also spoke with House Bill 648 sponsor, Representative Rappaport, last night.
Extremely disappointed. I think the bill is a shadow of, the bill was actually about eminent domain and how it was not applicable to participant-funded or private projects. My understanding is that the full bill will be voted on in the Senate on January 10th. We plan to continue to lobby senators, so hopefully the bill will pass on the Senate floor without this amendment.
The countdown to Christmas has begun with a holiday concert held at the Moose Muck Coffee House in Colebrook last Saturday night. Under the direction of music teacher Johanna Shillamat and pianist Sharon Pearson, a selection of holiday songs, old and new, were performed.
The third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me.
Last Friday night was a traditional late-night madness event, an evening where area stores stay open for longer hours, with people filling the streets of Colebrook for shopping and fun. Stores had spent the previous week decorating for the upcoming festivities, which can be seen in these photographs by Colebrook Chronicle reporter Brittany White. Late Night Madness is hosted by the Colebrook Downtown Development Association. Another local tradition took place on Sunday when Santa came to the Colebrook Gymnasium. The event was sponsored by the Kiwanis Club of Colebrook. We were finally hit with the much-awaited winter snow this week. Look for the snow to continue into the weekend with below-freezing temperatures. Saturday temps range from 24 to 11, and Sunday climbs to a high of 27 and a low of 17. The Colebrook girls traveled to Pittsburgh for varsity basketball last week in this game filmed by Chronicle reporter Liz Carney.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.